It's day two of the Minneapolis teachers strike after another day of talks. Both sides say they're still pretty far apart from finding that common ground. While nearly 30,000 students stayed at home for another day, teachers, staff and other educators did demonstrate, and some students outside of schools and at the state capitol. Of the thousands of people out there, and especially striking teachers, a pair stood out as they walked down memory picket lane. Here's Sharon.
59 on the line.
Former Bancroft Elementary School teacher Laurel Erickson didn't think she would be out here again.
People want to know.
Chanting and picketing.
Teachers are underpaid. Students are overstressed. The world in which they are growing up is hard.
If we don't get it, shut it down!
52 years after Erickson had asked for better working conditions during the Minneapolis Public Schools strike in 1970, she's joining another strike.
Woo!
This time for her daughter.
Shut it down!
Also a Bancroft Elementary School teacher.
My hope is that things will be better for students and to give them what they really need, lower class sizes and mental health supports and counselors.
Ramgren says watching her mother,
she
always knew the job wasn't going to be easy.
It does seem surprising that we're back in the same place that it feels like we've been fighting for and we shouldn't have to fight for.
You know them.
Revisiting better wages, support and smaller class sizes. Problems as old as the last strike.
I felt frustrated at not being able to meet the needs of every student. I didn't have time.
Yeah.
We need more help. We do. And I think this is a righteous cause. I really do believe in this.
And for education.
Problems worth braving the cold for.
Being in a wheelchair, my husband, I couldn't get here if he didn't bring me.
That's right. Thank you, Jack.
He supports us too.
In terms of support,
we are the counselors.
Ramgren says she's grateful for it, as she says it will help her support her students back.
I love my students and my families, and this is why we're here. We want them to be safe and have schools that are safe and stable. And I would say thank you for all of the support and encouragement.
Like mother,
just wonderful.
Your students have been very
supportive. They've been wonderful.
Like daughter.
You hear them honking.
A generation bound by education. Hoping for the same things.
Power of the people don't stop.
52 years apart.
This group of teachers is amazing to me. Bancroft is in good hands. The students and the parents support.
Yes.
I'm proud to have my daughter teaching here.
Sharon Yu, Care 11 News,
yes!
Minneapolis.
Thank you.
Well, from the picket lines back to the negotiations, like we said, we didn't get any word today that the sides were getting closer to a deal or further apart. But the district gave a statement saying Minneapolis Public Schools remains committed to meeting and negotiating with MFT, the teachers union, in order to reach a contract agreement in order to get our students back in their classrooms as quickly as possible.